crashing through the lies and disinformation. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us on this live Sunday worldwide broadcast, the 17th day of April, 2016. We'll be here for the next 2 hours. The entire 9/11 fraud is beginning to unravel. The 28 pages, you heard us talk about it 16 years ago or 15 years ago, the congressional report the year after. You've heard us talk about it in the last 15 years ad nauseum. And everything that we basically laid out has now been proven correct yet again. And Saudi Arabia is holding the United States hostage, threatening us if we try to bring the information out and if it's declassified. But first, a threat not of man, but of Mother Earth.
+44,000 people have evacuated the Japanese town of Mashiki on the southern portion of the Land of the Rising Sun following a 7.4 magnitude earthquake that has killed at least 9 and injured 858. If you have been paying attention, you may have noticed the frequency of earthquakes being reported in 2016 has been unyielding. Recently, a magnitude 6.5 earthquake hit Vanuatu. A magnitude 5.9 earthquake hit the southern Philippines. A magnitude 6.9 earthquake rocked Myanmar, and on April 10th, a 6.6 magnitude quake hit Kabul with aftershocks in India. On April 8th, there was a magnitude 4.2 earthquake in Nepal. Nepal was also hit earlier with a large 5.5 magnitude quake on February 22nd. And in the beginning of 2016, on January 20th, there was a 6.1 magnitude earthquake in China. And 16 days prior, 11 people had died when a 6.7 magnitude earthquake hit Manipur in India. Michael Snyder of End of the American Dream writes, "Why is the crust of the earth shaking so violently all of a sudden?" Seismologist Bilham of the University of Colorado has made headlines all over the world by warning that current conditions might trigger at least 4 earthquakes greater than 8.0 in magnitude. If his projections are accurate, our planet could be on the precipice of a wave of natural disasters unlike anything that any of us have ever experienced before. Basically, what we saw in Japan earlier today is tiny compared to the destruction Bilham has been desperately trying to compel governments all over the globe to be aware of. But Bilham has been turned away from at least one country that refused to hear the truth. In 2012, Indian officials deported Bilham when his plane arrived in New Delhi. Why? Bilham had raised concerns about the dangerous seismic activity in the Jaipur region where a nuclear plant was being planned. Meanwhile, authorities are quietly racing to monitor the many volcanoes blowing their tops. Currently, there are 38 active volcanoes as the Earth moves through its volcano season. The WorldNet Daily writes, "There is a 5% to a 10% chance in the next 80 years, scientists say, one of these eruptions will kill millions of people and poison the atmosphere beyond the imagination of anything man's activity could do in 1,000 years. And no one is yet making any plans to deal with the calamitous possibilities."
But earthquakes are earthquakes, and I don't know. Hopefully we just won't ever have to worry about it.
How does that make you feel, living here and running a business here?
It just feels kind of awkward. I didn't know about that fault. We've had earthquakes here in the last 2 or 3 months that weren't as big as this. But I'm just happy that I have a building that I know that can withstand it.
This relatively unknown fault line that was here, and you can see where the road has just separated into, it was pushed up against each other directly in this area. Sidewalks are about 3 feet high in some places. True to California fashion, some of the children have seen this as their opportunity to have their own makeshift bike ramps and skate ramps, trying to make the best of this situation.
All eyes should be on the Ring of Fire as the trenches activate the tectonic plates at exponential levels and earthquake news events multiply. John Bound for Infowars.com.
We'll be back. Stay with us. There is a paradox. Thank you for joining us on this live Sunday worldwide transmission, the 17th day of April, 2016. I'm Alex Jones, your host. I'm here every Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central. And then, of course, we return weekdays, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Central Standard Time, InfoWars Nightly News. Also airs 7 o'clock Central. Find all the details at InfoWars.com in the Listen and Watch section. This is primarily a radio/TV multimedia transmission. And, of course, we are simulcasting on radio and television. Anyone listening on radio can simply go to InfoWars.com/show to find all the free podcast, audio feeds, video feeds, Android apps, iPhone apps. It's all free. InfoWars.com/show. It's a paradox. My job is getting easier all the time because the globalists are just out in the open trying to hide their crimes in plain view now because they can't basically bamboozle or hoodwink the public into not understanding that it exists anymore. So what I was covering 21 years ago on air, what Barry Goldwater was fighting 50 years ago in the Senate, what Ron Paul was fighting 30 years ago in Congress, was very stealth. But now exactly what the old-timers told us they were planning, and they had the documents, was mainly government whistleblowers, top military brass, members of Congress, you name it, that went public. They'd write a book, they'd warn people, the mainstream media would make fun of them, but people listened, and the seeds were planted. And as the global government grew exponentially, but still incrementally, like a metastasizing cancer, there was countless individuals and groups out there that went out, did their own research, and verified what nationalist, pro-freedom patriots had warned them about. So those Paul Revere's, going back to 1913, that fought the establishment of the private Federal Reserve and others. Those patriots, the last 100-plus years, are the reason today we have a fighting chance. Think about how awake the general public is now to the fact that the stock market's rigged, the interest rates are rigged, the currency speculation is rigged, the gold and silver markets are rigged, that the Federal Reserve, again, is private. The public is beginning to wake up and understand that we have a multinational oligarchy of private offshore corporations conquering the globe and seeking to dumb us down and create artificial civilization that disconnects us from common sense and domesticates us because they've stolen the world. Now they want to keep what they've stolen. Now, that said, the paradox is it's out in the open now. But the part of the paradox that makes it not be so easy is that they're doing so much so fast and moving so quickly and don't care and have institutional control and don't get in trouble that they're above the law. And so there's this moment of collective cognitive dissidence, or it's beyond that, this moment of collective shrugging the shoulders and saying, what are you going to do about it? This moment of collective giving up. And not everybody's given up. But a large portion of people that are aware of what's happening just say, you're not going to change it. Well, let me tell those people something. If you lay down to tyranny, it will only progress and get worse like cancer. You have to throw sand in the gears of anti-human, unconstitutional, anti-family, totalitarian baloney. It's like saying, I don't want to have to breathe, it's work. You die if you don't. Or, I don't want to have to walk around the block with a dog. You know, it's too boring and it's tiring. You'll end up dying 20, 30 years young. You'll end up being in a wheelchair when you're 50 living like that. It's not work to fight tyranny. It's not work to be informed. It's animating. It's the animating contest of liberty. It's what it's all about. Now, that said, we've got a big, now hour and 49 minutes lined up before us here today. Incredible naked theft in Georgia where Trump won handily. They just took the delegates. The Associated Press announced it like it was no big deal. And that's the bigger story, is how the mainstream media goes along with this. Another headline, Infowars.com. It's also in Yahoo. Cruz wins another voterless contest in Wyoming. And he called it a, quote, grassroots victory of the voters, close quote. A total inversion of reality. So that's up on Infowars.com. We're going to be breaking all of that down. Ted Cruz celebrates Wyoming win, calling voterless contest a grassroots uprising. Party bosses plan to rob Trump in Wyoming and Indiana. Yeah, there we are a few days ago telling you about that. They've now done it. And don't worry, UN Human Rights Commission blasts Trump's hateful slander of foreigners. You know who runs the commission? Saudi Arabia, Jordan, and other dictatorships in the Middle East. That's actually who runs the commission, is Saudi Arabia. That's like having, I don't know, who's the most famous child molester in U.S. history? I don't know the answer to that. You guys ask Google who is the most famous or most notorious child molester. It'd be like putting a child molester over the local neighborhood watch program for children or something. Saudi Arabia that chops women's heads off that refuse to wear headdresses, beekeeper suits, and that chops homosexuals' heads off. But see, the homosexuals, they're mad I'm using the word homosexual. They don't care if Saudi Arabia chops their head off. I use the word homosexual not because I dislike you, but because you're not going to tell me what words to use. That's cult garbage. UN rights chief decries bigotry in the U.S. presidential race. UN rights chief. Jordan and Saudi Arabia run the stinking thing. We're going to get to all of that, and I've got a big stack of censorship news coming up from all over the world against nationalists, against fathers, against Christians, against patriots, against the most law-abiding, decent people. Merkel is going to arrest the person on TV that wrote a poem about the dictator, basically, of Turkey. He has staged elections, but it's admitted he kills anybody that gets in his way. Arrest newspaper chiefs, you name it. Ergun. Germany's going to arrest. See, by the way, even the Seattle Post-Intelligencer asked, man, the Black Lives Matter people and other social justice warriors, they won't let anybody have free speech. They attack people. Is that okay? Is that their safe space now? And they go, yes, it is their safe space. You don't get free speech when the left says so. The whole world's a safe space, a free speech zone for you. But they have free speech because they are fascist, brown shirt, lowbrow idiots. I mean, you go out to a Sanders rally or Hillary rally and these social justice warriors, I don't care if they're black or white, they can hardly talk. And we've got more than 30 videos on Infowars.com, Facebook. We shot them live on Facebook, live on Ustream, live on Infowars Nightly News, live everywhere. When I say 30 or 40, it's like 100 videos. I mean, I can't even count them. I couldn't even watch them all. They're all so insane. Like the worst 10 or 15 or so are on the website on Infowars.com. I mean, it is crazy. They were in New York where the anti-Trump people attacked free speech and went crazy and beat people up for no reason. Even folks who were just out there observing, they just beat them up. The police, of course, let them do it because that's white privilege to be attacked for your race and be left alone and no one protects you. And then our crew went out to Denver where they stole last week the popular vote. I mean, forget Donald Trump, whether you love him or hate him, they stole that. Our crew went and covered that Friday. And then yesterday they were in Portland, Oregon at the university where the left shut down six Trump supporters last week who were students and said, don't try to have free speech, it's over. We went there, we conquered, InfoWarriors showed up by the hundreds, and we restored. That's the real story. The First Amendment that's been fought so hard for since 1776 that these dirtbags wanted to bury. And Saudi Arabia is trying to hold us hostage. Stay with us. That's right. Raising the debt, the national debt, does not raise the debt. And now they've given the president.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Blanket control going out to the next president to just put us into any debt they want. We're being maneuvered into total receivership, total bankruptcy. And I want new listeners and viewers to understand something. You are not hearing rhetoric. I mean, this is what global government is. It's what the New World Order is mega banks controlling huge corporate combines, taking over nation states and maneuvering them towards total collapse. That is the Agenda 21, Cloward and Piven globalist program of dependency. So coming up, the theft of more states like Georgia and Wyoming, and they even had a popular vote in Georgia. But then when Trump won, they just said, no, we're giving it to Ted Cruz, like Tennessee, like Louisiana, and so many other states like Arizona. But instead, they're doing a new thing where they just go, oh, we changed the rules, or if we wanted to months ago, we can, in Wyoming and Colorado and all those other states, we can just not even have the election. And then when DrudgeReport.com and Infowars.com points out this is crazy and this is wrong, they have mainstream media come out and go, can you believe these nuts? They claim there's something called voters. But it is backfiring on the public. The public is understanding what's happening. They get that there is a fraud going on, and it's a huge wake-up call. I mean, look at this Hill article. RNC chief, no changes to delegate requirements likely. And then he goes on to say, yeah, the delegates could just represent whoever they want, even though they're pledged to the voters in the precinct. And then there's another article, Republican Party delegates feel sudden power as balance shifts. It'd be like if you had 10 employees at a restaurant and you showed up as the owner and they told you, we've formed a union, we're throwing you out, we own your business now. And they really believe, because they say so, that that's the case. It's like Kim Jong-un, the son of Kim Jong-il, the son of his dad, the dictator. They become royalty, and he really believes, waddling around, unable to tie his own shoelaces, that he is God Emperor of the poor slaves, and they can't produce anything. Worse than Cuba. No cars. They can produce nothing. Nothing. All they've got is a bunch of Chinese and Russian artillery and old rotting tanks from the 50s. But it doesn't matter. He's obese and went to a prep school in Switzerland, so it's okay. And there's lots of uniforms and lots of spies and lots of control over what language you use. And, oh, it's just such a big power trip. Look at the photo right above that one where he's looking off, the one next to it. Yeah, no, three, yeah, that one. Look at that. Look at the power trip. Murdering, executing whoever he wants. The guy can't even bench press probably 45 pounds. But he rules a state because it's perfect for him in history. Only a big bloated evil government would want such a thing running it. But all you pseudo-intellectuals about Bernie Sanders. By the way, when we come back from break, we're going to break in a while, but when we come back, Bill Clinton finally told the truth. I'm stunned by it. This is a big deal. We're going to cover that. So let me tell you what's coming up. Bill Clinton told the truth. We're going to get into the election being stolen all across the country by the RNC. We're going to get into billion-dollar lawsuit filed following Deutsche Bank's admission of gold-silver rigging. We're going to get into the world's strongest earthquakes now hitting, ever recorded, and the most frequent. And there's one area that hasn't been hit, and it's two-plus years overdue, according to all the mainline seismologists and people that study earthquakes and the volcanologists that study the volcanoes and the rest of it. A bunch of earthquakes today hitting Japan, a bunch hitting just all over the world yesterday. I mean, this is getting crazy. We're going to break all that down. And we're also going to be getting into, as I mentioned, the massive censorship and just outright political persecution going on by the so-called left. And see, the left traditionally are the ones sticking up for civil liberties and human rights. So the establishment worldwide is coming after rights from a twisted leftist perspective because they want to get the leftist opposition to stand down and put up with it. And it's a master stroke, but man, it's really getting crazy. It's really getting out of control. And we got Rob Deuce coming on at the start of the next hour. He's at DFW right now, just flew in from Portland. They were, again, in Portland before that. They were in Denver, Colorado, fighting against the theft of the election there that happened last week. And then, of course, before that, they were in New York, where the anti-Trump people were attacking just people that were out there for free speech, period. A lot of folks we talked to weren't even supporting Trump. They just came out to see it. But if they were white, they were attacked. One guy was out there promoting the Second Amendment and just saying, look, we need to defend free speech and the Second Amendment. So he got attacked and beat up, and the police did nothing. So I'm not looking for trouble, but any when I go to Cleveland and other places, anybody thinks they're going to knock me upside the head, I got some news for you. I kick like a mule and I bite like a crocodile. And so, okay, all right, go ahead. Go ahead, and I'll probably get arrested. It'll be on video. Somebody pops me in the head, I'm going to pop them right in their nose. I'm going to pop them right in their eye, pop them right in their throat, depending on... Somebody really goes after me, I'm gonna target. And just, you can find out. And I'm sure you're big and tough, I get it. In there watching Oprah Winfrey and TV all day and eating, you know, glow-in-the-dark GMO cereal. It's just that I am coming to execute the First Amendment, and I will defend it. So that's what it comes down to. It's just amazing. No, I will be in Cleveland with no bodyguards. That's what I do. I get down there in the street, folks. That's who I am. And good Lord above is my protection. And, I mean, I guess I've had a few concealed carry people here and there now when I'm out. But, I mean, whatever. The point is, some loon is going to do what a loon's going to do. And so I'm here openly saying I'm not a coward like Bloomberg, who has 15 bodyguards on average. We have video of it in New York, but after he was out, we visited Austin, other cities, trying to ban our right to own guns, people that don't have the money to have 15 bodyguards. And he'll have 15 bodyguards with guns, but he wants you disarmed and alone and cold in your home. And so many low-level predators aren't even part of the establishment, but they get this instinct to serve the establishment, and they love it, and they get off on it, and they think of themselves as the elite, and they love the idea of lots of little disarmed slaves, and they imagine how they're commissars and political apparatuses of the system. But the first thing I'm going to cover when we return, I'm going to start now getting into the articles. I've mentioned a smattering of what's coming up. Now we're going to start covering it. Do I get a Pulitzer Prize? Not that I want one. I mean, I wouldn't want a Nobel Prize for literature or a Nobel Prize for journalism or a Nobel Prize for peace, because they give them to Al Gore, Henry Kissinger, Barack Obama. It's like you know, being given Tyrant of the Year award or something. But I don't get an award for being the first to say they were going to stage an attack before 9/11 and then on 9/11, and that the Saudi Arabia was involved and our government stood down. It's now all over mainstream news headlines. Saudi Arabia threatens to pull $750 billion from the U.S. economy if Congress allows them to be sued for 9/11 terror attacks. Now, coming up next hour, we're getting into election 2016 with Richard Reeves popping in from on the road. Rob Dew and the crew at the Dallas airport flying in from Portland, where the left announced it. The Portland State College there, we do not allow free speech. We do not allow students to have Trump events or basically any other conservative events. And so hundreds of InfoWarriors showed up to say no to that. And they were out there all day trying to stop our free speech. They were shut down. That footage is there and more. Also, our crew up there reporting and openly being biased for voters, being able to vote, being openly biased to tell the truth, being openly biased to promote America and freedom. We were out there covering the hundreds and hundreds of people. The estimated about 400, Rob Dew did, demonstrating in front of the RNC headquarters there in Denver, where they just said, we're not going to have voters this time. We're going to suspend it, and the party is going to give the 34 delegates to Ted Cruz. And that's now happened a week later. Cruz wins another voterless contest in Wyoming. Again, he won Georgia, but it's been given to Ted Cruz, even though they had a vote there. The voters are just being ignored, and they're saying you are now ceremonial, and everything's normal, and you're a conspiracy theorist if you don't buy into that. That's coming up. But don't worry, the Saudi Arabian government is on the Human Rights Commission, and it's headed up by the Jordan government, that's the chair, and they're criticizing Donald Trump and investigating him, saying we should have borders. They have total control of their borders and chop thousands of people's heads off every year, including people for their sexual preference and orientation. But don't worry, Cirque du Soleil, I'm going to be covering this, is banning coming to a bunch of states that have passed pro-Christian laws saying Christians can't be persecuted, you know, if they won't bake a cake for somebody or something. But Cirque du Soleil is going to the Middle East, to all the top countries that murder anyone for their sexual preference that isn't, well, they'll kill you if you commit adultery, too. It's all bull. It's all about bullying America. Oh, Donald Trump said we might have a border. That's so evil. Look. Wall Street Journal, Chinese finance minister takes aim at Donald Trump's trade policies. Yeah, they have 35 to 40% currency tariffs on us. And then they tell us, we're screwing you. Nothing's made in your country. Ah, the Chinese generals own everything. We murder political dissidents, kill Buddhists, and sell their organs. And you listen to us, you Hitler. They called Trump, you Hitler. Does Trump have mobile execution vans? Does he kill Buddhist priests? No, you do. You do. And so you take, he's Hitler. Redonkulous. There is no end to the level of this bull. But now, let's get into Saudi Arabia. This is a big deal. Let's go to drudgereport.com. And I tell you, you go to Infowars.com, there's one little article linked there from a couple days ago when they first made this threat on Friday, down at the bottom of the page. You talk about a day late, a dollar short. We're 1,000 days early and got 10 trillion too much. I mean, that'd be the example of this. Because you'd think something that we're so on top of, that we were the progenitors of, that we took all the heat on, we'd be covering. When our time comes, but see, we don't do that. We're already light years ahead dealing with the latest. Like we told you 10 months ago, they're going to cancel elections and just give all the delegates to whoever the Republican anointed one is. We now know it's Ted Cruz. And here it is. RNC defends voterless elections. Don't give a darn. But look right here. I'm at drudgereport.com. Drudge is cutting edge, too. I'm just pointing out that he's cutting edge before, and then when it's time to be cutting edge, to take credit. We are way before, and then never give ourselves credit. And I'm not bragging about how accurate we are. I'm just telling you, folks, you should pay attention to us and realize we're already ahead to the next big thing, because we tend to launch any new movement or understanding of what's going on. Just like last week, we first reported on Russian jets buzzing U.S. aircraft carriers and ships. No one else was covering it. Now it's all over mainstream news. Drudge linked to our article on Friday, and then new events have happened, and Drudge has got those linked. And that's how Drudge leads the news. We lead the news as well. I'm just pointing out to you that, remember, in 2001, 9/11 took place. I was on over 120 affiliates. I was already on 120 affiliates or more. A lot of them big stations. And the station manager started calling, and they said, stop saying that there was a stand-down order and that Saudi Arabia hijackers were CIA, and stop saying that the FBI says they were ordered to stand down. Stop saying the government did it, or you're off the air. And I lost probably 80 affiliates. I lost close to 70%. But it's better than losing my soul. Now, a lot of those stations came back later and picked us back up. A lot of them have been bought or sold since then, but what I'm getting at is, in the beginning, a patriot's a scarce man, hated, feared, and scorned. But in time, when his cause succeeds, the timid join him, because then it costs nothing to be a patriot. The media misrepresented what I said about 9/11. They also built straw men. And they tried to shut us up, but we didn't shut up. And I had the FBI agents on. I had the whistleblowers on. I had them all on, folks. I had Springman, the head of the visa section at the embassy, whose associates told him they were ordered to let the hijackers in. It was a secret CIA program. I told you there were drills on 9/11 from our sources of the exact same targets being hit. That later all came out in mainstream news. And I risked my life doing that to tell the truth, because I'm not going to sit here when something comes out that is destroying human liberty and freedom and threatening our whole future. They use the attacks to take our freedoms and try to butcher our republic, folks. So I had a responsibility to expose it. And now I've had members of Congress on, former members of the Senate on, FBI translators on, NSA translators on, Sybil Edmonds and others. I've had them all on, folks. And now NBC News headline, secret 28 pages of 9/11 report under new scrutiny. Saudi Arabia threatens to pull $750 billion from U.S. economy if Congress allows them to be sued for 9/11 terror attacks. That's New York Daily News. Continuing, and this is the really important article right here. secret 28 pages of 9/11 report under new scrutiny, and then it goes into the U.S. government standing down. Here is the New York Post, how U.S. covered up Saudi role in 9/11. And when you cover up a role, you're now complicit. And they covered it up day one, ordering a NORAD stand down. And I've interviewed members of Congress that said they cried when they read the secret congressional report. Not the 9/11 commission, the congressional report that was done the first year. And then six of the 10 commissioners have gone public and said there's a cover up and that you need to have their report released. Not the public one, but their secret one as well. Who's vindicated? Who told you Saudi Arabia working with criminal elements of our government? And you see Obama today, this is bipartisan, working with the jihadis, working with them in Libya, in Syria, in Egypt to overthrow governments, working with them all over the world, protecting them, giving them weapons, giving them Stinger missiles, Benghazi, all of it. We have been proven right. And let me tell you why I savor this. Not because it proves I'm right, but because I did the right thing. I sacrificed career and future and tons of money. You ought to try being 26, 27, 28 years old. I'm 42 now, however old I was on 9/11. And to be sitting there out of my home studio on over 100 plus stations, some of them big, and the biggest syndicators in the world saying, we want to hire you right now. We want to pay you $5 million a year and a book deal. Come work for us. And you know what? I didn't do it. And I can stand here and be an honorable person and know I was right. I was proven right. I did the right thing. And now the globalists are panicking and in deep trouble, and it will come out, and all the rest of it will come out, and nothing on earth can stop it. You guys can start wars. You can have Al-Qaeda attack you brought into the country and divert from this. It won't work. We know criminal elements of our government and the global Federal Reserve Combine are running jihad operations as their secret proxy army with Saudi Arabia. And the whole thing's been blown wide open, and the Pentagon is now exposing it. Now, I use DrudgeReport.com as an example pretty much every show because it's the dominant news site in the world, more traffic than Facebook and the New York Times combined. And why? Well, I mean, Drudge sees them canceling elections all over the country or taking elections where Trump's won now in six states and giving it to Ted Cruz. And he says, wow, let's link to a headline pointing out it's voterless. And then Ted Cruz and the dinosaur media and the RNC come out and say, Matt Drudge used to be good till he started listening to Alex Jones and came to visit him. Alex Jones has done something to him. That's been in multiple newspapers. Glenn Beck says that. No. Drudge was on radio 15 years ago talking about human cloning and how dangerous it is. I mean, what are you talking about? And GMO. I mean, we got people like Ted Nugent and Chuck Norris coming out concerned about GMO because they've read the studies. It isn't a left or right issue. It's common sense that when you don't have an election, you've got a problem. Bernie Sanders keeps winning states and they're giving it to Hillary. I can't stand Bernie Sanders, but I'm worried about the integrity of our system when they steal it in the open. They've been stealing it for a while here and there, trying to at least. But now they just do it in the open in this big psyop. And why else is Drudge successful, just like InfoWars.com is? Well, because when it's in, you know, a congressman comes out a year ago, like Walter Jones, and comes on our show and says, you know, this is what's inside the 28 pages, and Saudi Arabia ran the attacks, and NORAD was ordered to stand down, and it's going to implicate the Clintons and the Bushes and probably bring down a major government, but it needs to come out. Drudge linked to our article. Because I guess Drudge was concerned. Oh, and look at the results of the families and Trump talking about it. We advised Trump to talk about it. He's also a New Yorker. I'm just going to leave it at that. We asked Trump to come out against the Federal Reserve. He did 1 week later. Roger Stone said, watch what happens next week. And it happened, didn't it? By the way, he didn't tell Trump what to say. Trump was already mad at the Federal Reserve. He just reminded him to bring it up. Turns out Trump's been reading books like None Dare Call a Conspiracy since the 70s. And I'm going to stop right there. But I'm going to tell you, I've been told by Dr. Corsi and a bunch of other folks that have known him for 40 years, Trump is a closet anti-New World Order guy. He just knows the stigma the media's push and is just bringing the issues out instead of the buzzwords, like the 28 pages a few months ago, and look at what's happening. See, pebble in the stream, pebble in the pond, and the ripples it sends out. Just like I told you a few months ago, the 9/11 hoax is coming down. They want to come out and say, Jones says Bush blew up the towers with Wile E. Coyote and TNT. And Jones says there's no radical Muslims. And Jones says all these things we didn't say. There is radical Islam. It is trying to attack us. Our government's bringing them into Europe and the U.S., not vetting them. So when they do attack, they'll take our liberties. That's the false flag. Open and shut, that you're letting them in. You're letting it happen. Just like in Europe, declaring civil emergency and banning free speech after they allow these attacks to take place. It's 2 + 2 = 4. It is cause and effect. They have the motive, they have the means, they have the history. They've been caught doing it. And now members of the Senate, members of the House, they've gone public and they say, okay, it's admitted. Well, of course it's admitted. The FBI, for all its issues. You know, I used to get tricked into just bashing different government agencies for no reason, just as if that was the enemy, that was the problem. That's where I realized, wait a minute, over all these years, it was the FBI in 7 states tried to stop the attacks, knew who it was, and was blocked from doing it in order to stand down, and then agents were demoted. Why am I buying into just bashing them wholesale? It's like bashing cops because one cop does something. It's just mind control. It's a bunch of George Soros baloney. Does it mean the government's not completely corrupt and out of control at the top? Absolutely. Should it be reformed? Absolutely. But Americans need to come together and fix this country and not fight with each other over race and whether you work for the government or don't work for the government. Most people I talk to, whether they work for the government or work in private industry, know this country's in trouble and want to save this country. I mean, we're in trouble, folks. The amount of evil out in the open is mind-blowing. Look at these articles. New York Daily News, royal scum is the headline. Saudis threatened asset dump if blamed for 9/11 showdown. 700 plus billion they're going to pull out of the U.S. Well, why are they running our country anyways? And Fox News is partly on, give me a break, folks. Saudi Arabia uses international terrorism. They've invaded Syria. They're behind ISIS and Al-Qaeda. It's their proxy army. It's on record. Secret 28 pages under scrutiny ahead of Obama trip. We need regime change there. Hey, you want to threaten us with your tottering dictatorship over there? You're like North Korea. Secret 28 pages under scrutiny ahead of Obama trip to Saudi Arabia. Now USA covered up Saudi Arabia role. Oh, how the U.S. covered it up. How the U.S. covered it up. How the U.S. covered it up. That's in the New York Times. That's in Bloomberg. That is everywhere now. That is in the news. That is in the New York Post. What are you going to do, bad boys, when they come for you? And let me tell you why this feels good. I will defy death. I will do things that are risky if I have to do it first. And I'm so sick of sitting around and seeing nobody else do it, and I got to hit the barbed wire first. But I'm ready for other people to hit the barbed wire. I'm ready for other people to take the risk and be part of history as well. I have responsibility when I know something to tell the truth. It doesn't mean that I like the consequences. You think I like saying about all that advertising money in all those stations? When they took me off all those stations? You think I like the death threats? You think I liked all the other dirty tricks I had to go through? The character assassination operations, not just from mainstream media, but armies of trolls, armies of stalkers, stuff I could write best-selling novels on. But it had to be a novel to protect the innocent. But, you know, it's all exciting. It's the animating contest. The persecution's kind of fun. It's interesting. It becomes, let's just say my life's not boring. So I'll tell you, I know that I'm the first to expose 9/11 2 months before it happened. I said they're going to blow up the World Trade Center, blame it on their asset, Bin Laden. I did it the day it happened. I exposed the whole thing, the drills, all of it, had all the big whistleblowers on, had the deputy head of emergency management on, who was dead 2 weeks after he was on the show, Barry Jennings. I mean, you know, I'm proud of the fact that, you know what, I'm a man. I'm proud of the fact that I don't cower in fear. I'm proud of the fact that I told the truth. I'm proud of the fact it's all come out. And more and more and more is going to come out. And people look at me and say, you're a weirdo because you think voters should vote in the election. And I'm just like, okay, whatever. Hey, says fluoride gives you brain damage. Harvard study. You want to point at me and call me a kook because I got hundreds of studies? Okay, whatever. The truth is, I know what I'm talking about. A bunch of dumb, unintellectual people who are uninformed. want to have the proper accent, the proper outfit, and act trendy and wear all black or whatever they do, or you know what trendies do, and or have the beard like the funny guy from The Hangover. If you were smart and had the beard like the beard like the guy from The Hangover, then you'd be cool. Not against beards or tattoos. I'm just sick of people that are all hat and no cattle. We're going to come back and get into the other news. The massive chilling attack on free speech happening everywhere. This is so incredible. Wait till we get to this, because they can't win debates with us. They've got to shut us down. But 9/11 truth is coming out, being proven right, being vindicated. All of you that stood up for 9/11 truth, you're vindicated. All of you that got attacked for speaking out about it, you are just as important as I am, or more important. To all the whistleblowers, to everybody in the government that told the truth and went through hell to do it, to Sibel Edmonds and the FBI agents and the visa people and all of them, the thousands of whistleblowers that got persecuted, good job for standing up for humanity. We salute you. When I tell you how satisfying it is to tell the truth, be proven right, and be vindicated, it's not for my ego. It's for other people to know historically the truth will come out in the end. Briefly, if you'd like to support and get super high-quality products, the absolute tip of the spear in the fight for human liberty, InfoWarsStore.com's got the best non-GMO heirloom seeds, the best high-quality storable foods that last 25 years is fresh and super high-quality. InfoWars Select, powered by My Patriot Supply. InfoWarsStore.com. You will get the lowest prices on storable food, the highest quality, lowest prices out there on the widest spectrum of non-GMO heirloom seeds, of Hillary for Prison t-shirts, and an unprecedented 45% off our flagship brain pill, Nootropic Brain Force. 25% off is what it's normally discounted at off the retail. It's 45% off retail now, 25% off the discount. Find out what this nootropic's got in it today at InfoWarsLife.com. DNA Force with Bio-PQQ and the highest quality Resveratrol and just everything else. Just go check out DNA Force. InfoWarsLife.com is the nutraceuticals. InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsStore.com is the umbrella site, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can answer all your questions. 888-253-3139. I'm Alex E. Jones, fighting from the state of Texas against the globalist juggernaut. Hour two straight ahead. All right, I would normally be taking a lot of calls on the Sunday broadcast, but I've got Rob Dude joining us from DFW Airport to fly back to Austin. He just connected in from Denver. Denver was where they were a few days ago, from Portland, and then before that, New York. So he'll be popping in about the bedlam, the insanity, the censorship, the attempts to attack free speech, and the successful attacks in some cases in New York, in Denver, and particularly in Portland. So that's coming up. And then Richard Reeves pops in. 33 after at the bottom of the hour. But I do need to dovetail all of this with chilling. German Chancellor Merkel agrees to charge citizen for anti-Muslim poem. But it wasn't. It criticized the dictator, basically. He's at staged elections of Turkey. But look, we have free speech in Europe and the United States, but they don't now if it's against the leftist, communist, weirdo, group-controlled corporation, radical Muslims. It's crazy. And they bring them in and say, we can't let them attack us. You have no free speech. Do whatever they say. That's what's going on. So I'm going to be breaking that down. Bernie Sanders, liberal supporters, do they expect safe places everywhere? And the Seattle Post-Intelligencer, also, the New York Daily News also has an article, but it's Alan Dershowitz, who, by the way, said I shouldn't have free speech, basically. It's strange enough. I shouldn't be able to have guns either. Said I was dangerous just because I was yelling on CNN right after I was on with Piers Morgan, but that's a side issue. Even he gets it, and so it was in AP, but it was in the New York Daily News and also the Seattle Post-Intelligencer. So that's why I said I'm like plugging it three places, because it was like three places, but it's an AP article. Or a New York Daily News article that got put in the Seattle Post-Intelligencer or whatever. Didn't know they did that. Bernie Sanders, liberal supporters, do they expect safe places everywhere? Safe spaces. And then it goes on to admit that they basically attack people all over the place that don't go along with their views. And that's what we've experienced. Also, three states ban travel to Mississippi, but they don't ban travel to all these different Muslim countries where they kill gay people. And there, I'll use a politically correct term. Whatever. It's not that I dislike people that I want to use the word heterosexual, homosexual. It's that it's another thing. We'll use the word gay. Now use the word disabled, not handicapped. And soon it's don't use the word mother and father. See, they get you in the habit of use this word, it's less hurtful. Or it's more loving. And then now we're going to arrest you if we don't use the word we say. Well, you know what? It makes me want to use the N-word and the F-word and all these other words just because you say ban them. Or only certain groups can use them. It's just all bullying is what it is. In the freest Western countries in the world where you've been allowed to do all this and get taxpayer paid for sex changes, you want to now pull down the family and the free market and the engine of everything that gave you what you've got, stupid. And then, of course, the cherry on top, Cirque du Soleil cancels North Carolina shows over Public Facilities Act. Yeah, because it doesn't have a transgendered bathroom. Planned shows in Dubai where gays are put to death. That's in Reuters. Even gets the hypocrisy. When I saw that, I'm like, that's Reuters? This is a Reuters photo. It's Breitbart. But, I mean, this is just absolutely getting crazy at this point. And Facebook censoring people that are pro-Trump. And they argue, they have all these news articles going, it's good they're censoring. Zuckerberg owns it. Shareholders own it. They're allowed to. It's their property. But you hold it out as your own little commons and your place for your views and your place to communicate. It's false advertising when you do that. You hold it out as a place where, as long as you don't violate these terms and conditions, we'll let you say whatever you want. But now they've changed them to disagreeing with someone or hurting their feelings. And then you can selectively decide what to do with your little AI computers. They're also censoring stuff about Saudi Arabia and 9/11. They're censoring all sorts of Benghazi stuff. I mean, people are like, well, why are you on Facebook then? I go to Facebook to have that platform to push people to my platform while I warn people we may not be able to be there that long, or YouTube or anywhere else, because let me tell you, they're doing everything they can to kick us off right now. We're going to Rob Dew and our crew stranded in Dallas, Texas. I come to you from Austin, Texas. Because of the horrible thunderstorms that canceled flights, he just flew back in from Denver and New York and Portland. That was where they were traveling. The last port of call would be Portland. Just showing the social justice warriors trying to ban everybody's free speech across the country. And then they've got the RNC stopping popular elections, which they've had previously. But they say it's no big deal now that they're just giving all the delegates to Ted Cruz. But then if he wins Tennessee or wins Louisiana or wins Georgia or wins Arizona, they still just give the votes to Ted Cruz. And they say there's nothing to see here. Nothing's happening. No big deal. And I was thinking about back when I lived by the lake, and there were neighbors who had some family members that worked at the University of Texas. And we were out on the community dock. And I was just thinking of political correct. This is like 5 years ago. And there was this UT. She wasn't a professor. I think she was a, what do they call those when you're just like a teacher? Point is, I'm out there fishing with my son at like 7 a.m. in the morning, and she walks over, and she goes, we're here with gypsies. You don't have a problem with gypsies, do you? And I'm like, gypsies? Like Esmeralda from The Hunchback of Notre Dame? I'm like, no, you mean Romanoff people? So you know about it. You know how it's all a lie that they do anything and rob anybody anything wrong. And I'm like, look, lady, I know there's some reformed gypsy groups, but also I know there's Irish pikies that rob people. I mean, oh, really? Oh, I was like, look, I'm sure they're nice. And I'm like, what's going on? Well, we're just got some gypsies here, and we're, you know, having a cultural exchange with them from UT. And, you know, they're very wonderful people. And I'm like, okay, great. And I'm sitting there drinking coffee and eating a honey bun, literally. My son's trying to catch a catfish. He's like, you know, 7 years old at the time. He's like 13 now. And he's got a birthmark. Everybody's seen videos of the Rex reports he's done. It's not as big as Gorbachev's or anything, but, you know, it's a handsome little stork's bite, as they call him. They're on the side of his temple. And then she turns, she goes, and she looks at me, she goes, did someone hurt you, young man? Are you okay? Did someone hit you? What happened? I'm sorry to ask, I just have to ask, sir. She looks at me, and I'm like, she goes, it's my birthmark. And I can tell you how many times I've had a weird, trendy white woman walk over to a restaurant and say to my son, even if he's 3-4 years old, did someone hurt you? And then I knew, and I was like, hey, let's go over here and fish. And, man, she was around 3 days. It was on the weekend. And just literally on my butt to keep me in line. And that was kind of my first big run-in. I told you about Halloween last year. It's my cousin's birthday. I go on this cruise with him. He, you know, got a paddle boat on Lake Austin, the river. And it's called Lake Austin, but it's really Colorado River. And then we went back over to a club. He had the top rented out, but it was still open to the public. And I had multiple people come over because I was wearing a captain's hat. And I guess I'm a white guy with somewhat blonde hair. And they asked me, are you a Nazi? And I'd say, no, it's a captain's hat. And I turned back, hey, because I don't like Nazis. I'd say, hey, you're looking for trouble. I'm not a Nazi, but you want trouble, you little social justice warrior. You're about to get it. You little control freak. You want power. You're an insecure weirdo that's been taught by the universities how to go out with what's the proper term? Assertiveness training and get in white male's face. Well, guess what? You're in one's face. It was white women, Arab guys, you name it. It's just like, look, you're looking for trouble. You want some simulated combat with your words and your worthless degree you got that you can't get a job with, but you learned how to brainwash people and learned how to obsess over words, and now you're here messing with me. And that's what's going on. I thought I'd just preface this segment the next because they're about to get out of the airport and I'm going to go quick to them so they can come back and put a big compilation of the 30, 40, 50, I don't know how many videos there are. They shot in New York, Denver, and out in Portland, Oregon, where they were just announcing, Trump supporters on the streets, you will be attacked. You have no free speech. We played the videos last week. So our crew went out there. Hundreds of InfoWarriors showed up, particularly there in Portland because that was our deal. Our crew were speakers, Joe Biggs and Rob Dew, and they stood up against being spit on and attacked, having bottles thrown at them, and faculty trying to shut down their free speech, but they did it. In America, you have to fight for that or lose it. But I'm telling you, you got a freak looking at your kid going, did someone hit you? And looking at the dad going, I'm sorry, I have to ask. Like she's some FBI agent caught me in something. And I'm sitting there trying to catch fish with my son at 7:30 in the morning. This is the whacked out world they're in, man. You got to understand, it's all they got. They don't know language, literature. They're not intellectual. They know how to dominate and mess with people. And I've got stacks of articles we're going to get into showing it. You criticize Turkey or the Turkish government in Germany, you're arrested. You criticize radical Muslims in France, you're arrested. This is where they're going. I mean, I was in Rome last year, and I saw gypsies robbing people. You can go to YouTube and type in, there's thousands of videos. But I've got to be henpecked how they're not robbing anybody. Well, these people probably were nice folks. Fine. They were Americanized. That's great. The point is, I'm not here to have guilt over you. I didn't do anything to you, you freaks. I'm successful in my own world, social justice warriors. I don't need to go around jacking with everybody, henpecking everyone. Police won't hand stolen caravan back to couple to protect human rights of the travelers living in it. See, it's a gypsy culture to steal your travel wagon. That's what they call it in England, until you're allowed to keep stolen RVs there. Sorry, just side point. I'm just thinking of those white people. They deserve to have their life savings, their retirement home stolen. I mean, you know, screw them. I agree. I'm a social justice warrior. So, just breaking down what you faced in New York, in Denver, and then in Portland. Break it down. What was the worst? What was the best? What are some of the most amazing moments, the videos people should go look at on InfoWars.com, Rob Dew, from the airport?
Well, Alex, I was just informed by the police here that we don't have a permit, so we can't be talking to you right now. What I'm doing is obviously an illegal act of communication. And
But they can videotape you and let jihadis into the country.
Right, exactly. So I was just informed by the cop. Our plane's been delayed till 9 p.m. You know, renting a three-city tour, starting off in Manhattan, going to going from Manhattan to Denver, then to Portland.
I know you're super tired. You barely got sleep doing this.
So, yeah, the cop's over here talking with Biggs right now. It's kind of funny.
Listen, I don't want to get in a confrontation with him. Look, they're going to take his pension fund. The country's gone. Everybody knows it. And we can't have slaves with a camera in there without a, quote, permit inside of the, quote, supposed public space where they can all surveil us, but we can't do an interview in there.
Yeah, exactly. And we told him it was just on Skype. So he's like, you don't have a permit to film here. But regardless, you know, seeing the light and dark of humanity on this trip has been really interesting. We saw, you know, paid organized protesters going after Donald Trump in Manhattan. And then we went to Denver to watch some pissed off Americans who are just want their right to vote. That's all they want. That's all they're asking for.
Now, wait a minute. You're claiming people used to vote. That's a known conspiracy theory hate crime. Right. That hurts delegates' feelings. Delegates are in the news saying they feel powerful now. People may start actually paying to be delegates. It's a new royalty, dude.
Well, yeah, I think that's what it's going to end up happening, is you're going to see people pay for the privilege of getting to vote. And, you know, it just boggles the mind. And then yesterday we ended in Portland with the pro-Trump rally. And I don't know if you watched all the Facebook video and other videos that we put up, but it really is interesting. These people have no interest in dialoguing or even talking. They're beating on buckets, blowing on whistles, just, you know, cussing people out. They threw some ice on a kid, like an icy thing hit him. They had some of the pro-Trump people had to do a citizen's arrest, but then the cops let the guy go, and he was obviously intoxicated. And he said, we have it on tape saying somebody told me to do it. It's just crazy. But it was good to see a lot of people came out from different locations, from Idaho to Washington State to California, all coming.
Well, listen, I don't want you to run afoul of the police. I'm sure if you went and sat over there in a corner or something, they wouldn't care. The citizens don't like to see a fellow slave with a video camera. That upsets them. Only government can body scan our naked bodies. Get a rent car, come back to Austin, or stay till 9. I think they're going to keep canceling the plane, dude. So just try to call us from the road. If I was you, I'd just get out of there. We're going to come back with more of the news. You know, I'm really glad that Nico and Dari and others just reminded me. I mentioned this last hour. I said, coming up, I'm going to get into one time Bill Clinton told the truth. I'm going to do that right now and then get back into the news ahead of Richard Reeves joining us. I could have pushed it at the Dallas airport with Dew there, but Dew looks so exhausted because he planned this trip. I was like, you're going to be in New York on Thursday, Denver on Friday, Colorado, and then Portland, Oregon on Saturday, back Sunday. I said, okay, if you want, if the crew wants to do it, you guys knock yourselves out. But the videos they've got, I mean, some of them are just comic gold when you hear how stupid these Hillary and Bernie supporters are. But I shouldn't laugh at them. They're dangerous, folks. Their ignorance is very, very dangerous. But getting back to Bill Clinton, Bill Clinton helped give us the current housing bubble and derivative scam. That's what he helped get past. Bill Clinton came after our guns. He did so much more. By the way, Hillary's back on the news wanting a 25% tax on firearms purchases. But Bill Clinton said something that was actually true. He's been bashing Black Lives Matter lately, pointing out that they're connected to violence and things. But he's also been coming out trying to act like they're more populist and pointed out that some Bernie Sanders supporters would like to basically shoot folks randomly on Wall Street. That's a good point. It's the big mega banks that run the insider crony deals. And then the rest of Wall Street, the rest of free market gets blamed when it's Goldman Sachs and JP Morgan and a few others that are actually financing the big government and the control and the domestication of the people to make us dependent. And then they scapegoat capitalism. But to hear Bill Clinton actually tell the truth about Bernie Sanders supporters, because I know Roger Stone says that Hillary is hiring Bernie Sanders people who are so ignorant they don't know that when MoveOn.org and others who are really supporting Hillary bust them somewhere to shut down free speech, that gives Sanders a bad name. And maybe that's true. But most of the people we've had try to come up and say, you don't have free speech, are wearing Bernie Sanders shirts. And man, when you got a communist, and that's what socialism always turns into. Hugo Chavez said he wasn't a communist and admitted he was before he died. They play this game. Socialism always leads to communism. It's another form of totalitarianism, an ism. These people really just want a free ride. And they think they're so intellectual, it's really frightening. But mainstream media demonized me when I said that Bernie Sanders would want to put Americans in forced labor camps. I don't know a communist government that doesn't do that. as it begins to fail. Bill Clinton, Sanders' backers would shoot every third person on Wall Street. If Bernie Sanders were elected president, his supporters would shoot every third person on Wall Street. Former President Bill Clinton joked Friday, stumping for his wife Hillary Clinton at an event in Fort Washington, New York. Clinton jabbed Sanders and students who supported the Vermont senator's attacks on corrupt financial systems.
One of the few things I really have enjoyed about this primary, quoting him, is I think it's fine that all these young students have been so enthusiastic for their opponent, and he sounds so good. Just shoot every third person on Wall Street, and everything will be fine, he said.
Obama, when he was down in Argentina a few weeks ago, said, communism and capitalism aren't that different. They need to work together. Multinationally, you need capitalism, but locally, you need communism. Yeah, George Soros is above the law, tax exempt out here, and you're in a slave pit, in a slave factory, under communism with a general that lives in a giant palace and has 15 mistresses and houses all over the United States and Europe. It's always the same. But it doesn't matter. Bernie Sanders supporters wear black shirts with a shot of his head with curly hair. Like, look, he's smart. He doesn't care about his hair.
To Walmart, have hundreds of billions of dollars. I'm going to give it to you. He doesn't tell you Walmart made deals in the 80s with the CIA and the Chinese communists to have select deals when nobody could compete. Well, they run all sorts of other monopolistic schemes. He doesn't come out against monopolies. He's the capitalism. Look, I'm an old guy from Vermont. Never had a job. There's a lot of money. I'm going to give it to you.
I saw this guy when I was jogging on the Greenbelt today with his Bernie shirt on. He thought he was so smart. This old guy, he kind of had hair like him. And then I saw his car when I went back up. I could tell it was his car. I'm guessing it's his car. And it said, I love Obamacare. I almost took a picture, but I was so tired I didn't do it. And then next to it, Bernie Sanders. 2016. Because now,
you vote for me, you're going to get the free health care.
Like you got under Obama. Oh, I'm sorry you didn't get that. You got increased prices. I'm sorry. And I've talked to big hospital chain owners and people. I mean, I'm friends. I've been to a few parties. I own a few boats. I mean, I could say I'm acquaintances with people that, you know, fly to work in a helicopter. And they just go, oh, it's so immoral. Yeah, we're making double, triple profits, but it's all the small places are getting shut down to medium-sized and city-owned hospitals and county-owned ones. They have no idea. It's big multinationals, and we're making double, triple profits. He goes, you know, I could buy 15 Ferraris this month if I wanted to, yeah. It's so immoral, but it's legal. I've just got to do it, Alex. You're absolutely right. I'm talking about, well, my dad got out of, you know, management of over 100 clinics because he wouldn't be part of this. And he's like, well, yeah, no, that's one way to go. But, you know, things are going to be so corrupt, it's all going to collapse. You just got to go ahead and get yours now. You know, my dad wouldn't be part of that. He wanted to make a small profit in a free market and deliver high quality to people, and he couldn't do that in the system now. He'd have to go lobby and be parts of all these deals, and my dad just said, I'm retiring about 3 years early. At the peak of his career, not just as a medical practitioner, not just as an oral surgeon and a dentist, but as a manager, as one of the top, you know, managers in his field in the country, I'd say top 10. Consulting all over the world, all over the country. And he said, I just can't be part of this. But you know what? There's a lot of folks that are going to be part of it, and they're going to take all those little Bernie supporters who think if they've never had a job, can't tie their shoelaces, but they've got hair sticking out, and just, you know, it's all about, oh, I'm wearing different colored socks. I watched The Hangover Part 3 9 times. And they're all about restricting free speech. They're all about shutting down people's free speech. They're all about... And then you actually talk to the controllers, and they go, listen, Alex, we agree with you. This is super immoral and evil. But I'm telling you, you ought to just join us for a while just to protect your family, because I'm looking at, I don't know where I'm going to move. Where do you think is safe for me to get out of here? You're talking to some guy worth like $1 billion. They're like, and they meet another billionaire. You know, I mean, these are real billionaires. And they're just like, hey, listen, we're actually not against you. We agree with you. But what do we do when the system's, it's designed to screw everything over and take everything over, and it's going to crash. It's going to be horrible. What do we do, Alex? I'm like, I don't know. All I try to do is analyze it and tell the public that they're too busy watching TV and acting cool and putting on Bernie shirts and, you know, going and mom's going to get a second mortgage to put Billy to get his second degree. He couldn't get a job with the first one, but Billy's 25 now and mommy's mortgaging the house. Our son's going to get 2 degrees. He'll get 3. He's going to be a doctor. Try being a doctor when everything collapses and it's the road with people running around eating you in the streets. Richard Reeves, for months and months, has been following the Trump campaign, the Cruz campaign, the Hillary campaign, the Sanders campaign, filing video reports every single day on the nightly news, almost every day, every few days on the radio / TV transmission that we're hosting the Sunday edition of right now. And let me just remind everybody, it takes a lot of money to have 3 reporters and 2 camera people in New York, Denver, and then in Portland in the last 5 days. And then to have Richard out there roving with the rest of the great crew, it's expensive. And to have the writers, the researchers, the crew behind the scenes that are just as important as, you know, anybody out there. They're like the folks at Cape Canaveral or Houston for the space missions to the astronauts. We need folks to go to InfoWars Store. That's InfoWarsStore.com. And whether it's a Hillary for President shirt or a Molon Labe come and take it shirt or 25% off the already discounted price on the best nootropic out there, Brain Force or DNA Force or X2 or Silver Bullet, Colloidal Silver or Lung Cleanse or the Oxy Powder, you name it. I was just talking to a fellow today. His wife, you know, everybody's getting these bowel disorders because of all the GMO and all the garbage. And for about 6 months, she started taking Oxy Powder every few weeks. And guess what? Her inflammation is gone. She's better. I'm not saying it's a panacea for anybody, but it's just higher level oxygen that releases in the upper and lower intestine and, you know, really cleans everything out. Some stuff sold out, like Anthroplex. But the joint formula that's just, well, what is it, 9 of the best-known organic compounds to help with your joints and inflammation and to help the joints, you know, basically continue to be healthy or to, well, it does a lot. Just check out joint formula, InfoWarsLife.com. Check it out. Today is the subsection for InfoWarsStore.com. Again, that's InfoWarsLife.com is the subsection where you find all of the high-quality nutraceuticals that we produced with the top laboratories in the United States. These are true game changers where I set out with the top scientists, chemists, nutritionists, experts, medical doctors, you name it, to develop the ultimate high-quality, affordable nutraceuticals with wide-spectrum benefits. Super male vitality, super female vitality. Take Secret 12. It's just super high quality methyl cobalamin. 80% of it is that. And then the other 20% is another type of vitamin B12 that helps you absorb it better. And it is just simply amazing. Most of the stuff you go to the doctor to get synthetic. This is the real thing. So many other products, InfoWarsLife.com. And we also have free shipping on orders of $50 or more. Free shipping at InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. And we also have other great deals there on the site, like 10% off when you sign up for AutoShip, whether it's our non-GMO, organically grown, southern Mexico, high mountain Chiapas, volcanic soil grown coffee, or whether it's Secret 12 or Supermel Vitality, something you might want every 15 days, every month, every 60 days, every 90, you can choose right there and get 10% off, cancel anytime with the auto ship. InfoWarsStore.com, again, is the umbrella site for all of that, and your purchases make the broadcast possible. Now, I want to go to our reporter, again, who's pulled over, Skyping in, Richard Reeves, somewhere in Pennsylvania on his way to Buffalo, New York, to cover the big Trump primary that he's set to sweep. But we've got a major problem here. Whether you love Trump or hate Trump, I like him because he's a nationalist and against China and others having unfair trade deals. It's very, very simple why the Chinese president and the Chinese official communist papers are calling him Hitler when they have mobile execution vans killing their political dissidents. It's because if they have a 35 to 40% tariff, it varies, it's always going up and down on a daily basis, set by the Communist Party against us, we can't compete in China. Plus, no environmental standards, no human rights. I mean, you just can't compete with China because it's rigged. And Trump says that's going to stop. And he's given money to anti-NAFTA and anti-GAFTA initiative. He's spoken out against it for 25 years. That's why they hate him. He's got some problems, but he's a nationalist. He's a real person. They've got his number. They're scared. And you've got the Saudi Arabian government on the Human Rights Commission and others coming out saying no Donald Trump. You've got all this other censorship. You've got the Pope and the Mexican president, the former Mexican president, telling you as a citizen, bullying you, you can't have Donald Trump. And now in Tennessee, in Georgia, in Arizona, and all these other states, Louisiana, he wins by 10, 20 points. They just take the delegates, and Ted Cruz wins. And then Ted Cruz, last week in Colorado, this weekend in Wyoming, here's the headline, Cruz wins another voterless contest in Wyoming and has the nerve to call it, quote, a grassroots uprising. Man, I got to tell you, Richard never liked Ted Cruz, and he's been heavily involved in Texas politics forever since I met him 14 years ago. He's a delegate, you name it. He used to go to the RNC DNC with me many years ago. So Richard's an old hand at this. He predicted all this happening, you know, 10 months ago on air, got Roger Stone on. But I got to tell you, Richard, I'm really amazed at how naked and brazen they are. And it really freaks me out. I mean, I wonder what's next. The big banks say they're getting ready to do bail-ins, grab part of our bank accounts. I mean, this really shows how far down the rat hole we've got. So you've got a lot to break here today. A whole cornucopia of issues that you want to break down, some of the inside Republican baseball you've been getting when you've been in all these big meetings and at these events, and Stone and others helping you get behind the scenes. Now they're calling for Stone to be banned everywhere. They're claiming we're calling for violence, when the truth is they're the ones intimidating free speech everywhere. Richard Reeves from looks like a roadside park there in Pennsylvania.
That's right, Alex. Thank you very much. That is Interstate 80, one of the lifelines of this country. There's so much freight, so much trucking that goes across that. When I was a truck driver back in the 80s and 90s, unbelievable amount. That's the aorta of the United States right there, right along with I-95, I-35. But anyway, that's not what we're here to talk about. Basically, this is like that scene in The Wizard of Oz when you, Alex Jones, Toto, pull back the curtain, and the wizard is back there feverishly flipping levers, hitting buttons. Don't look at the man behind the curtain, and that's why they're acting the way they're acting. I mean, they are really pulling out all the stops, and one of the reasons you were talking about, you know, they hate Donald Trump for all these different reasons, and one of those is because I think the issue of 9/11 truth prior to this election season was kind of like one of those Wile E. Coyote Roadrunner cartoons where Wile E. Coyote is running up and he's about to go off a cliff, but he puts the brakes on, he's sliding right to the edge. And he comes to the edge, and he's got one toe left on the edge of that cliff, and he's just perfectly balanced, and he can potentially keep himself from falling off. And Donald Trump comes up, and just a little puff, and the Wile E. Coyote, 9/11 truth, going off the cliff in a big way.
That's right. For those that don't know, it's all over the news, mainstream news, saying our government stood down 9/11. Bare minimum, allowed Saudi Arabia to attack. And obviously there's more to it, but when this comes out, it is huge.
It is huge. Alex, this is not going away, I don't think, this time. On at least probably three of the big Sunday talking head shows, this issue came up. And I think on every one of the 9/11, or every one of the big Sunday talking head shows, this story about Saudi Arabia potentially threatening to take $750 billion worth of investment in the United States. Talk about, are we worried about invasion? Hey. Invasion has happened. If they have $750 billion worth of assets.
We're being held hostage by a third generation dictatorship who literally ran a white slave trade, kidnapping women on the trade routes. I mean, that's who the Saudi royal family is the literal scum of the earth, slavers.
Right. And just think about this, that they would make this threat. Oh, we're going to pull out our $750 billion worth of investment if you guys pass this legislation that 9/11 families can sue governments. Well, I tell you what, you know, just about everywhere I know of in the United States, a jury and a judge would say, hey, that sounds kind of like an admission of guilt to me, Alex.
Sounds like terrorism to me. We're about to go to break. You've got a bunch of other points you're going to cover when we come back. Some of it breaking news on the campaign. Tell us what's coming up.
Well, one of the things that's coming up is, you know, they've amped up the Hillary-Bernie horse race. Bernie lost this race a long time ago. The super delegates, we talked about that way back in January. I think they're just amping it up to try to take some of the focus and some of the energy out of the Donald Trump campaign. But, you know, it just seems like...
And the big one, Paul Ryan, you're going to hear it here first, is listed on FCC documents or Federal Elections Commission documents as a candidate getting ready to run for El Presidente with no votes. They'll just give it to him and he'll say, no one ever voted. What, is that conspiracy theorist Alex Jones or Matt Drudge telling you you vote? There was never votes in America. I was listening to that liner. 3 or 4 years old. We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance. And it was like when you go over a big hill in a car and your heart drops. I was like, we are the heart of the resistance. We're in trouble. We're about the best there is. I'm on the opposite of a power trip, folks. I'm running around here like a chicken with my head cut off meets Paul Revere. Just saying, look, folks, they got hundreds of farms across the United States growing humanoids inside cows. People say, so what's the point? We're not in Kansas anymore. And I was talking to my lawyer last week, and he said, yeah, my paralegal brought this up to me, that you're talking about humans growing in cows. What's this craziness? So I showed him a news article. I texted it to him. I was talking to him on the phone. He goes, wow, that's in MIT. And I went, yeah, man. Yeah, there's a lot of crazy stuff going on. That's all I'm saying. And we got to get a handle on this. It's out of control. I interviewed the FBI agents that were ordered to stand down before 9/11. I interviewed the NSA people that heard the calls. I've interviewed the colonels that were ordered to stand down. I've interviewed everybody, basically. Because I was the only one crazy enough to have whistleblowers on. The fact that I'm alive really is a marvel. I've told the story many times about my dad's first cousin. He called him his uncle because he was 10 years older than him. He died a few years ago. He just marveled that I wasn't dead because that was the job he had, was going out and getting rid of people here in the United States for the Army. I mean, the public just needs to grow up, okay, and realize that we have an arrogant, out-of-control government that thinks it's God. And it's not God. And I mentioned this earlier, so I should play the clip or folks will say it doesn't exist. It's Bill Clinton has his truth moment. Bill Clinton, Sanders backers would shoot every third person on Wall Street. That's actually a true statement. They're a bunch of evil people wearing Sanders shirts with red flags, with hammers and sickles, saying they're not communists, beating people up in wheelchairs. I even saw that in New York. I mean, and they can't even fight. People sit there and let them hit them. Like they swing their fists from the side like a four-year-old child would do. I mean, what are they going to do if they hit me and I, like, break their nose? I mean, and if I want to be mean, I'll aim up. I mean, what are you going to do when you get punched by a real American? You're going to sue me, and then I'll have to go to court and show that you hit me first. I mean, I don't want to break your nose. If you punch me, I'm going to break your nose. Maybe I'll just break your jaw. It's kind of like a trick breaking somebody's jaw. It's almost like it's magic. You just got to punch full power, totally relax, punch them right on the side, and just go, yeah! And then their jaw breaks most of the time. I guarantee you this, they go down to the ground. Get me an old man. That even hurt my shoulder doing that first little explosive move there. And it's nothing that I'm special. I'm just a throwback. I'm the standard model off the shelf 100 years ago. You understand that? People need to ask themselves, what have they become? What have people turned into? By the way, people say, oh, you're not tough like you could. Hey, whatever. I go out without bodyguards, folks. What's that tell you right there? Tells you that I'm not living in this cowardly fantasy land. I live in the real world. Back to Richard Reeves. Richard, you've got the floor till we end this transmission. Run through this laundry list. You got a bunch of stuff. Paul Ryan gearing up to run, saying he won't. Other important tidbits. Richard Reeves.
All right, Alex, thanks. You know, coming out of that bottom of the hour break, you were talking about the InfoWarrior support. Not only financially, but also their prayers. I believe strongly their prayers have protected you for all these years. Who'd have ever thought that when you started this program back in the mid-90s, here we are in 2016, we are on the field, folks. We are making history. The reason the New World Order is doing all the ridiculous things they're doing is because the InfoWarriors are on the field. We are there. We are taking them on. Look, we've got a front runner that has talked about 9/11 truth, and he's the front runner. Come on. So the InfoWarriors, their prayers, their financial support, we're going to bring liberty and freedom, not just back into the United States, but we're going to bring it globally, Alex, and that's what's going to happen.
We are. You got a laundry list of stuff you texted me. It was really powerful. You said, Nico.
Let me hit this point about Paul Ryan. You know, Paul Ryan came out last week, said, no way, no how, I'm running for president. Well, it turns out that Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan have filed statements of organization with the FEC as late as back in 2015, several documents, and the latest documents that have been filed with the FEC.
Wait a minute. You mean they lie? They lie? Next, you're going to tell me we used to have elections.
Well, he told the truth that he wasn't going to run for president, but he didn't say anything about not running for VP. So he's already made a deal with Mitt Romney. If they have to parachute somebody in, it's going to be Mitt and Paul Ryan.
Who were on the ticket together 4 years ago.
That's right. They were on the ticket together 4 years ago. I guess they spooned and got along well 4 years ago, so they're going to try to do it again. But here's my thing, Alex, is the establishment, one of their gambits is going into Cleveland. One of their gambits is they've always had a giant establishment majority in these conventions at the RNC every 4 years. They're counting on trying to have that again, but I got news for them. I think we're going to have an anti-establishment majority of 60 to 70%.
I was about to say, even Politico has an article about all these white-collar and even wealthy liberals that are sick of deindustrializing America, all these Reagan Democrats, basically good liberals that are liberal socially but don't want to destroy the country, and that their polls show blacks, you name it, massively going to Trump. I mean, look how many Hispanics he's been getting in different states in the primaries. That's why they're having to steal it. They're panicking. Everybody knows he's not Hitler. What do you think of the communist Chinese generals calling him Hitler when these people are the closest thing to Hitler I've seen?
Well, you know, all these international leaders, they're just pulling their hair out because they're worried about Donald Trump cutting off their big financial gravy train with manufacturing, with jobs, with just...
They've hijacked the country, sold America out, and they can't even believe he would dare think about stopping it.
Well, they're used to having pallets of cash dropped on their countries out of C-130s, and they're facing that might get stopped and that somebody might actually care about the American people. As a nationalist like Donald Trump. So these international leaders, yeah, they're wetting their pants, they're quirking in their boots, whatever you want to call, whatever cliche you want to use to say that, hey, they're really wide-eyed. And
I know this. This is an incredible time to be alive. What else is coming up? What are the ramifications of Colorado? You pointed out that Hillary's totally won and stolen it. That's a total distraction horse race. What else is going on?
Well, and when Bernie is not the nominee, I think a lot of those Bernie voters are going to come to Trump in the general if we can get Trump through the nominations process and make him the nominee. Now, one big thing I think is going to happen is, you know, this 9/11 truth thing coming out, I think actually it may play a big role in the RNC in Cleveland. I think this could be the issue that actually wins Trump. Let's say Trump doesn't get his 1237, which 1237 may change because of Colorado. Let's talk about Colorado for a second. Colorado, I think it's going to be the Alamo. I think it's going to be, and I think that for Ted Cruz, he's going to be on the Mexican side of the Alamo. I think for Trump, he's going to be on the Texan side of the Alamo in Colorado. I think that this is just reinvigorated, re-energized, kick-started again, the Donald Trump train. So I think that Trump will end up getting very, very close to the 1237. I think there's going to be big challenges on the Colorado delegation. We're going to probably see challenges on Texas delegation. We may see that 1237 actually come down if delegations are not seated. So that's another thing to watch out for. Then looking forward into Cleveland, I think what may happen is this 9/11 issue. All right, Ted Cruz has his issues, but his supporters are constitutionalists. Ted Cruz supporters love the Constitution. They're patriotic. They're just not fully on board with 9/11 truth. Not completely, but I would say 25-30% of Ted Cruz's support are 9/11 truthers. This last push here started last Sunday by 60 Minutes.
I totally agree. And are we not totally vindicated as 9/11 truthers? They've always misrepresented us to say we don't believe there's radical Islam. We're the ones exposing it, and that there's an alliance at the highest level of the globalist operation with them. And as that comes out, I tell you, it's really hurting the New World Order. I totally agree with you. And again, it's Donald Trump helping take us over the edge, you know, in this march down the 100 yards to the goal line. We are a half yard in, and we've got two or three downs to get in, folks. It is ours to lose this fight. In closing, Richard, what's coming up in Buffalo? What's coming up in New York? How big's the landslide for Trump?
Well, the landslide is going to be good here. The GOP is fractured. The GOP is not homogenous. Yeah, they did well in Wisconsin. They're doing good in Wyoming, Colorado, and some of these other states. But the GOP is not homogenous. They're breaking. Probably about 15% is breaking towards Trump. Cruz has got a little bit. Kasich has, I don't know.
Maybe. So they're having trouble stealing. He's looking at maybe a 60% victory in New York?
I think it's going to be approaching 60%. And let me say right now, a prediction, I think 9/11 is going to play a key role in Cleveland. If Trump can't win the first vote from the delegates, I think he talks about 9/11 truth coming up.
That's right. And that's why they're scared. They know he's getting ready. Don't give it all away, Richard. It's the battle for the Republican. You're all part of it.